Hey there guys, this is my new channel. Starting it, it's gonna be a good sturdy channel. I have plans for it in the future, but if you're wondering what I've done in the past on YouTube, I had a channel, you can go check it out, but this is my nice, good, well-running channel that I'm trying to put actual hard work into. But the future holds the stuff like I'm gonna do overlanding, camping, bushcrafting, all kinds of stuff, just have big plans. But for today, I'm just gonna do my EDC. EDC stands for Everyday Carry. And that can be anything from your phone, a camera, a pocket knife, to even your belt. Just the simples. First thing on my list, a little bundle of paracord here with some Gorilla Tape. You can use both things. The Gorilla Tape for just taping stuff up, the paracord for tying stuff up, just anything. Just great to have a little bit of this stuff with you. You can just, so many things you can do with it. Next, on my list, I have my limited edition Benchmade Proper. This is on me almost every day. It can be the rest of the stuff on this list interchanges and mixes around a little bit. This is gonna most likely always be on me. It's a great knife, and a little something I did to it was added a red scale from one of the original Proppers to it. So it's my little take on it. It's cool. Alright, next thing on my list here is my trusty Leatherman rebar. Made in the US, leather sheath made in Mexico. Great leather sheath. Very well put together, sturdy leather. You got a serrated blade here. You got a saw blade here. You also got your screwdriver there. And you got a bottle opener slash can opener there. Over here, you got your knife blade. You got two flatheads. This can be a pry bar and this can be a scraper as well, but these are the flatheads. This is your awl, and here you have a file with, like, I guess medium grit, heavy grit, and then the like saw type of file down there. You also get a lanyard hole right here that's separate from everything else. And here you have some sort of wire cutters up in there. And as well as here, you have like fine wire cutters and heavy wire cutters. And you have your needle nose pliers as well. And if you can't see it, there is measurements there in inches and centimeters. Fits in the sheath very nicely. I originally was carrying a Leatherman Wave. This was basically everything but like the scissors and a few other things. It was just a different variant. Whereas if you're using a screwdriver or cutting something, everything's on the inside, so it's very smooth, but everything on the wave is on the outside, which I guess is better for accessibility, but it's not as comfortable in the hand as this one. So that's why I switched over to this. Plus, this is a much smaller compact package, so that's great. Next, I have my Bose Wireless Free earbuds. Now, the reason they're called free and wireless is because they're actually wireless. They're great. They're $200, which is a little pricey. And, oh, real quick, this is like $60. Sorry, all right? This is around $200. That's a bit pricey, especially for it coming with this huge carry case. You don't have to have this for them to work. If they're charged, you just take them out and you can just carry them like this. You just put them in your pocket. But, if you really want to charge them, you better have a backpack or something. Or you put this in your back pocket. I would not put it in your front pocket for obvious reasons. If you know what I'm talking about, you should know what I'm talking about. If you don't, then you shouldn't. Next, we got my Apple Watch. So this is the original model. It's not the free or whatever it's called. Sport. It's just the stainless steel version. The first generation. They say that it wasn't waterproof, but this is waterproof 100%. I put a nylon band on there. I marked where the loop is that I use every day, just so I could see it easier. Great, 42 millimeter. This one originally was about $200, I think. 200, so I don't remember, it's been a while. Next, if you don't know what this is, then just stop watching. Nah, this is my Zippo. Now, it's easier, you can just buy a Bic or something, but for me, I kind of like the aesthetic this has. I put my initials on there, CO, play with this. Very heavy duty. I chucked this at a squirrel and it hit the pavement. There's a dent right there. Stories. Give this to my kids someday. This one's about 50, so 50, 20, I'm not sure, somewhere in between $50 and $20. Great windproof leather. Just a classic too, why not, you know. Next, my wallet. This is, it's supposed to feel kind of like paper, but it's untearable. Like, you cannot tear it. It's great. It looks like money, so this is a great way to get mugged. But it's what I got, and it's what I'm carrying right now. Honestly, do I have my good wallet here? I don't have my good wallet here on me. This is just what I'm carrying right now because I couldn't find anything else. I usually just carry some cash in here and some receipts. That's about what I carry in there. You can unfold this, and like if you wanted to, you could hide a razor blade or something in there, just so that, I'm saying hide because you don't want to like just fall out in your pocket or something, but you could unfold this to find the razor blade if you need it in, say, a survival situation. This runs about 20, 30 bucks, I think, maybe 10, not sure. It's somewhere in between $30 and $10, not that expensive, but it is kind of expensive for what it is. Next on my EDC is this. Of course you can't carry this to, say, at the mall or a party, but if I'm carrying a fixed blade, it's gonna be this. This is the K-Bar Big Brother with the leather rivet handle. This runs about $100 even. You got a straight edge up here and serrations back here. So it's best of both worlds. It originally was coated with the black oxidized coating here, but I took it off. I tried to strip it and it didn't work, so it's kind of just messed up and like really like beaten and like just looks very rustic, I guess. I put some rubber O-rings in there for a little extra grip, but they kind of just come flush, so it's kind of just like a little bit smoother, I guess. Kind of just gives it a different look. I like it. It's very thin, but it's high carbon steel, which means it will rust easier, but it's very strong compared to stainless. All steel basically starts carbon, and they add stuff to it to make it stainless. So this is just very strong, hardened steel that will rust if you don't take care of it, but usually I haven't had an issue with that. On the sheath here, this is some paracord underneath this Gorilla Tape. There's paracord, which adds retention to the sheath when the blade is in there. And then back here, I have some of the 550 cord as well. Use the Gorilla Tape if you need it in a survival situation, and the paracord, of course, and this paracord down here. As I said, it adds retention, so I'm not holding on or anything. See, it does come out, of course, because it's just a leather sheath. It's not supposed to hold in there. But if I didn't have leather on there, I didn't have the paracord and Gorilla Tape, it would come out way easier. Look, I won't even hold on to it. Takes a while, so definitely recommend that. Final thing on my DC list is just this nylon Columbia belt. You buy a pair of Columbia shorts, this most likely will come on them. It's just the Columbia, just a sturdy, I'm assuming cheaply made belt, but plastic clip and everything makes it super lightweight and it's durable as all get out, and it was free with the pants. I'm sure I paid for it when I bought the pants, like I'm sure it was in there somewhere and I paid for it, but to me it was free, and I take it off and I use it. It's comfortable, it hasn't bothered me a bit. I'm not a big belt buckle kind of guy. I don't need a big belt buckle. I don't want something super strong, but as you can see, it is coming apart there. Of course, it's not supposed to be super strong, but as I was saying, I don't want a huge belt buckle, but this does give me a little bit of a belt buckle, so, because if I'm, like, crouching over and stuff, I don't want to get uncomfortable and stuff, so, I don't know, maybe pick up a pair of shorts. It's just an idea. You'll see it on there, but this is my belt I use every day, and so far, it has not failed me. It's super comfortable, and you can take it off and use it for stuff, tie stuff up with it. You can stop bleeding with it. You can use it for tourniquet and stuff. There's just tons of uses for this. You can use it for survival and stuff. So it's great. I totally recommend picking one of these up. So yeah, guys, that is my personal EDC. Just for now. The solid things that are always in there, I can pick a few things I'll always have in there out. One, my Leatherman rebar, always in there. Just, say I need a file, there's a regular file over here, and there's this, I'm gonna go for this. I don't know, just, this is just great. Love my Leatherman. Another thing that'll be in there, Zippo, just great, easy to throw in there. Might need a lighter, why not? Watch, of course. Belt. And earbuds. And my knife. Now, that isn't everything. If you think I just pulled everything out, it's not everything. The wallet, paracord, and the knife aren't there because I don't always carry those. But I will always have this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 things on me. Just always. And of course, one thing I did not forget, iPhone 10. It's not worth $1,000. Get a Samsung or an iPhone 7. I 100% say get an iPhone 7 over the 10. I didn't try the 8 or anything, but I can say with no doubt, just a regular iPhone 7, not the Plus or anything. iPhone 7, love that phone. Get it in matte black. It's just, it doesn't quit. It's a great phone. I didn't even have to replace the iPhone 7. I just got this because it was cool and I just wanted to be part of the fad. So I recommend iPhone 7 over this. Like, subscribe, leave down in the comments what you want to see in the future. I have plans though, so you don't have to, but it'd be cool. So like, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Love you guys. Peace.